sophisticated archive samplers can't do things like that. So you need very simple equipment like a TX81Z, which sounds horrible, which is what you really get. Go to the room.
And at the end of that piece, there was a piano solo which lasted quite a while.
And that solo is now here in a synthesized version, which has different aspects. So it sounds more precise. It doesn't have the musician's shaping of it, but judge for yourself. It's called Pandora. It uses regular tuning, and it was also done using the same program. But in this case, the program was run in parallel, or should I say in series. That is to say, running on one computer, the same program gave a second computer information, which it took as control information, so that it was the same program receiving from itself to compose. Both scores were rather small in size, and the computer did most of the work. That is to say, I did, but I let the computer believe that. The first piece was about 4 minutes in length. This is about double.
Thank you.
So the third piece is going to run right now on this program. That is to say, it will be composed right now according to a list of instructions that I've provided. And it's a strange coincidence, but this piece is about double the length of the previous. So it's 16 minutes long. It consists of 20 sections, of which the first section is 8 minutes in length. And each section following is half the length of the previous. So you can work out the length of the 20th section. And within each section, there is a very static situation, which gradually speeds up towards the end. And then it reaches the next section, which is also then static and then changes towards the end. So it's always a kind of a curve like this in every new section. And at the end of the piece, you find yourself in a transformed way at the beginning again.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.